Welcome back to another episode of City Skylines on Turner Mountain. In last episode we built this trucker stop area and it looks freaking gorgeous. And we also built this town over here. And one thing what I forgot to do is actually terraform this mountain over here. So it doesn't look that nice, but it's also a good thing that I didn't terraform it because I was short on time. I also am short on time still. But what I want to do today is actually start off with building some sort of a small countryside airfield. A local airfield, not a big one, just a local one where like small planes land. And what I want to do is actually, I want to start building that local airport probably closer to the top of the mountain, somewhere over at this side, and then probably terraform this a little bit better. So I will do that via time lapse, and I'll see you guys after that. Hello there, welcome to another commentary during the time lapse. And what you'll probably see me build right now is actually I'm building the airport itself. So what I'm doing right now is using the Move It mod to actually place the hangars at a really nice place. And man, the Move It mod, that's a really great mod. I will talk about it after the time lapse as well, but that's just a lifesaver time wise and also like how you place stuff, because it is crazy what you can do with it right now. As you can see, I will probably use it a lot during this time lapse, and you see probably gonna see me using it right now because I'm trying to make this taxiways a lot nicer and it turned out really badly. So I just used the Move It mod, just make a draw out of it and then just place it in, and I think it turned out pretty nicely. So what I'm actually creating over here is a fueling parking spot for like airplanes who need fuel. They can just stay there and yeah, they're gonna get fueled up and ready to go back into the air. So I'm using like the no parking lines and like the no parking yellow lines, and I think it turned out pretty nicely, and quite ironically they're used for like parking. So what I want to say over here, I think it turned out pretty nicely with what I'm trying to build over here. So with like those lines in the parking area, I'm gonna move it a little bit, and I'm also gonna use like the same lines or the same no parking lines for like smaller parking spots for like smaller jets, as you can see me do right now. I'm placing like 3 or 4 of them. I'm making them look nice, and after that I'm gonna move them with like the Move It mod. Once again, it's a great mod. So in a little bit what you're going to see are, we got a couple of problems with like moving the parking spots to the right positions. You will see me try and fail again, and after a couple of times I actually managed to get it right, so I'm really happy about that. So let's actually talk a little bit about the airport itself. What we got going on is we got like one runway and we got like 2 hangars and a couple of outside spots where the people can store their planes, and I think it turned out pretty nicely. So it's just a local airport with like people can park their planes or like the private jets. This is not like these big commercial areas and like where you need to go to security. You can actually just hop on a plane and actually fly away. So that's basically what I try to go for, like a nice area, nice local airport. And as you see me do right now, what I'm actually also doing is like creating my own runway or my own taxiways. I think it turned out a little bit better because the taxiways generated by like another mod didn't work out that well, so I just used my own, and I think it turned out pretty nicely. What I'm doing right now is actually just place like a couple of concrete slabs to make room for like the helipad area where helicopters can actually land. And what I didn't know at the time, there are actually two different kinds of helicopter landing zones. So there's one big one and there's also one smaller one. You will see me place like the big one, and after that I will swap it out to two smaller ones. And I think the smaller ones are a little bit better to use because they're a little bit smaller and can also use two instead of one. So it turned out pretty nicely as well. So what you guys will see in a little bit, I'm actually gonna start placing lots and lots of props, like helicopter props, but also like some fueling props, as you can see me do right now. I'm actually getting some assets. I'm just placing them via the movement mod once again. And this is really handy about the movement mod. I can just select a couple of things and just move them a little bit closer to like the road or to like each other. And I think that's the real strength of the movement mod. I really like that. But this commentary is gonna come to an end. And I hope you guys enjoyed this little commentary. So what you see me doing right now are just placing like a couple of props, and this is gonna be like the fueling area what I talked about earlier. But what you're also gonna see in this time lapse as well is like lots and lots of decoration. But I'm just gonna start playing some music, and I'll see you guys at the end of the time lapse. And we are back. So guys, hope you guys enjoyed the time-lapse. And what we got going on is ourselves a local airport. And it just looks freaking awesome with lots and lots of detail. And I'm really happy about how the thing turned out. So let me actually zoom in a little bit. And let me also get out of this view. Because we're gonna actually zoom into the entrance of the airport. And just look at this. Just the amount of detail over here. We got like some barriers. We got some barriers we're actually blocking the taxiway. So if you are entering the airfield, you are not able to drive straight onto the taxiway. And yeah, what we also got going on is of course a couple of security people. We got like some police props over here, or some police people props over here. We got some police cars. And it just looks freaking awesome and detailed. I really like it. So what we got going on in this airfield or airport, it depends on how you look at it, is we got two places where helicopters can actually land. We got like five places where planes can actually land or stay. So we got like three for those smaller planes or private jets, and we got like for those larger private jets, we got like two hangars. And you can see like one is actually taking off right now on the runway. Just the amount of detail, it is just crazy. What I recommend for that is using the move it mod. You guys suggested that in the comments down below, and it has been a lifesaver and a game changer for me as well, because it is so freaking handy. You saw me do that, or you saw me build this airport without, or with the mod. And without the mod, actually, I couldn't have built this airport. So thank you very much who suggested that in the comments down below. And if you have suggestions, just leave them in the comments down below, because it will always help me out. And yeah, let's actually move on. Moving on to the other side of the airport, or like the dirt road area of the airport, because this is not actually a part of the airport, but it just looks freaking awesome. It's actually connected to the airport road, because as you can see, we've got like the normal road, then it's actually divided into two areas. We've got like the entrance of the airport, and we've got like the dirt road. And just look at the amount of detail straight away after you enter this dirt road. We've got like some broken fences with lots and lots of bushes, greenery, trees. And it just looks freaking awesome. I'm really happy about how the thing turned out. It just looks freaking gorgeous. Let me actually get into the different view again, into the cinematic view. Because with the cinematic view, it just looks that much better. I'm actually gonna zoom out a little bit. Because just look at the amount over here, look at the amount of detail tried to put in. It is just absolutely breathtaking. For example, over here we got like our little pond. I actually extended it a little bit. And just look at this detail, look at the flowers and like the bushes and the grass and stuff. It is just absolutely crazy. For example, over here, what I did, I actually placed like a couple of abandoned cars close to the water. And I think it just gives that much character and that much detail. I'm really liking it. I really like this area. What we also got going on is, of course, the curvy roads, the curvy dirt roads. And I did that with the move-in mod. Like, it's a lifesaver and it's a game changer once again. So what we also got going on is ourselves a really overgrown abandoned building. As you can see, you are not supposed to see the building actually, because there are lots and lots of trees in the way. I should have thought about it when I placed it, but just look at the amount of detail once again. We got like a little path going at it. As from the main road, you have like a little path that's connecting to like this abandoned house. And yeah, that's the amount of detail I try to go for. Actually, let me get back into the cinematic view. I'm going to just follow the path a little bit, or like the road a little bit. And right now, as you can see, you've got like lots and lots of curves in here, in like the road and stuff. And I really liked it, especially like on the dirt roads. I really like the curves. And as you see, it goes up and down. It goes up and over the mountain. And then it actually goes a little bit back to like the airfield, as you can see in a little bit. So as you can see, like, we are going straight to like the runway with like the fence and stuff, and then we'll actually continue like to over on this side, whereas also you can see like the railroad, and the railroad is actually divided into two areas. We got like the normal railroad where trains are actually passing by, and we got like an abandoned area, because back in the old day they used to have like a railroad going over this mountain instead of like tunneling through. And as you can see there, yeah, they have closed it a little while ago, not that long ago. Their trees are actually start growing, but lots and lots of grass. And I think it just gives this area a really nice character. I'm really liking that I've added that in. And what I want to do with like this this road, this dirt road area, and like the railroad itself, is actually move on and let them slope down into this ravine or into this valley area, because I think it's gonna look awesome. So let's move on to the final area of this magnificent project, and that's actually gonna be the farm. So I actually had some room left and I decided to actually place a farm over here. So what we got going on is ourselves the farm area itself. We got like a little house where the farmer's living. We got like a barn and we got a big shed with like an RV and some hay bales and some other stuff. It just looks freaking awesome. The amount of details I put in over here, we even got like a water tower, we even got like a wind turbine area you see like in American farms, and it is just freaking crazy, the amount of detail. We even got like wooden fences, fencing the entire thing off. We got like some stone areas or some stone tiles actually going to the backside of the shed area where there's some smaller shed, and we got, yeah, we even got like some gas storage or some fuel storage where they actually can store some fuel. So yeah, it turned out pretty nicely, and we've got like a little back area where the children are playing. We've got like a swing set, we've got like a goal area or like a soccer or football goal area without a net. So I think it turned out pretty nicely. Then the barn itself, we even got like the, some harvesters. We got one over this side who needs to start working. We got like three over this side who already are start working. And as you can see, they're actually farming a little bit, or they have started on this job. So yeah, I think it turned out pretty nicely. So guys, that's gonna be it for me today. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more content. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care and goodbye.